thank you for joining us this morning. On Facebook Live, we thank you for joining us this morning. You could have been on anybody else's broadcast, but you decided to join us this morning. Can we stand and can we thank God for our apostle as he's walking in the door? Hallelujah.
It's one thing to just, I promise, I'm opening up and I'm sitting down and I'm making it.
We're coming into the new year. My watch is wrong anyway. We're coming into the new year.
Amen.
And right now, more than ever, leaders are being very strategic.
Amen.
By looking in that Bible. Hear me well.
Amen.
They're looking in the Bible and they're comparing events that happened in certain times and comparing events that are happening now to try to figure out what is about to happen next. You with me? Okay. Okay.
Yep.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Yep. Yep.
They're looking in the Bible now, comparing events from here and what's going on now to figure out what's about to happen
next.
Watch this. It's one thing to be biblically inclined. It's one thing to be able to compare details of then and now to try to figure out what's going on next or what's about to happen next. It's one thing to try and compare it. But the thing about it is that yes, there's nothing new under the sun, but the Bible also says in the book of Isaiah, behold, I do a new thing.
Always God does a new
thing. So here's what the Holy Ghost told me last night when I came here, and I was spending time in the presence, and he told me, he said, listen, he said, it's one thing if you compare details from two different times.
Amen.
But the thing is, it don't necessarily mean that the end or what's about to happen next is the same.
Amen.
You got to really go with me on what I'm saying. And I got like a minute left. It does not mean that the result is going to be the same.
Amen.
Okay. Here it is. Okay, thank you, Holy Ghost. The God used Elisha to part water. The same way, and you gonna be here where I'm going, right? God, listen to that, church. God used Elisha to part water.
Amen.
In the book of Second Kings, or was it the First Kings?
It's in Kings.
It's in Kings. And now, if you look in the Old Testament, God used Moses to part the sea. Two different people, two different anointings, two different situations. But the end result was different.
Amen.
Y'all know it. It's all right.
Amen.
The events were similar. But if you're so caught up on what happened then, and if you're so caught up, watch this, if you're so caught up on how God shows you what's about to happen next, if you're so caught up on how God used to show you what's about to happen next, you'll miss the new thing.
Amen.
The Bible says, because here it is, and I hope that there's at least whatever amount of
just read the Bible, but you must read the Bible and be able to have a revelation to hear from God. Can I give you scripture to back up what I'm saying? So no matter one thing that I'm a false teacher, here it is. The Bible says, man shall not live, this one comes to a close, by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. Which simply means this. The word bread in the Hebrew, it means logos, which means the written word. See why it's important to put your Greek in Hebrew? So you can actually know what the text is on.
Good morning.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
He said, the man shall not live. I'm coming to a close here. 10 seconds. The man shall not live by bread alone, but it is by every word. Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds, which means that God is always talking.
Amen.
That proceeds.
Amen.
Which means there's always something to say. Now, can I flip it so you can really feel like you're not lost? I need to help three of you because some of you feel like you're lost, but here it is. All because you don't hear God talking don't mean that you're wrong. All because you don't hear the voice of God don't mean you necessarily in sin. So there's a time where God, it's not that God is quiet, he's just not talking to you.
Amen.
Oh, I did that.
Amen.
There are times God is not that, because I heard some people say, oh, well, there's a season where God don't talk. No. No, there's a season that God don't talk to you. Because the thing is, truth be told, the thing is, as long as God is still talking, okay, can I get 10 minutes? As long as God is still talking, we feel comfortable. Can I help you good here? As long as we can still hear his voice, we know that we're not too far gone. Okay, let me break it down like this. Let's say that you are a child and you're running out in an unfamiliar area, like you're running in some trees. You feel confident as long as you can still hear the voice of your mother or father. Why? Because I know if I can hear them, more than likely they can still see me. So if something goes wrong, I know they got me. But the moment I go out and I can't hear the voice, now I'm nervous. Why? Because I feel like I'm all by myself.
Amen.
Long as I